Hello guys, it's Deepshaw over here and today I'm going to show you how to create this slice face color effect in Photoshop. Also, if you want to learn how to create such cool effects using Photoshop, then hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. So without wasting any time, let's get started. So this is the model image where I will be creating the slice face color effect. So the first step over here is we need to just select the face of the model in the image. So for that, select quick selection tool. And then using it, make the selection of the face in the image. You can use the square bracket keys of your keyboard to increase and decrease the size of the brush. Now if you want to deselect a selection, then all you need to do is click on this minus brush icon. And then using the brush, click on the selection you want to deselect. Now again, if you want to make a selection, then click on this plus brush icon. After that, I'm zooming into the image to make sure that the selection is proper. So now the selection looks proper, so I'm zooming out of the image. So after that, click on Refine Edge. So after that, make sure that the edges of the face look smooth. So you can adjust the smoothness accordingly. You can hover over the edges to make it look more smoother. So now this looks proper. After that, click on OK. So once the selection is complete, after that click on Add Layer Mask icon, which will only keep the selection, that is face, and remove rest of the image. So now this looks proper. After that, create a duplicate of this image by pressing Ctrl plus J. And now hide the original image, which will be our backup. So I'm renaming that layer as backup. After that, make the duplicate image layer active by clicking on it. And then right click on the mask of the image and then select apply layer mask over there. After that, select crop tool. And then using crop tool, you can expand and change the size of the image as follows. So now this size looks proper. After that, click on the stick icon to crop it. Now after that, we need to convert this image into a black and white image. So for that, click on create new fill or adjustment layer icon. And then select black and white over there. After that, set the red, yellow, green, cyans and blue accordingly and then hide it. So this looks proper for me, so now I am hiding it. So now we need to merge the black and white layer and the face model layer. So for that, press Ctrl and click on the duplicate face model image layer, which will keep the selection of the black and white image layer and give you the selection of face model layer. After that, press Ctrl plus G to merge the two layers into a single group. After that, create a duplicate of this group by pressing Ctrl plus J. Now our original group layer will be our backup. In case we do something wrong, we don't have to start from scratch. So I'm renaming it as backup black and white. After that, make the duplicate group layer active by clicking on it and then right click over there and then select merge group. So as you can see, the group has been converted into a single layer. After that, create a new layer by clicking on create new layer icon. And then select brush tool. Brush as soft round. And then set the foreground color as any color of your choice. You can increase and decrease the size of the brush using the square bracket keys of your keyboard. After that, using brush tool, make the partition of the face as follows. So now the partition looks proper. After that, make the face image layer active by clicking on it. Now we need to break the face image as per the partition we have created. So for that, select pen tool. Now if you are not okay with the pen tool, you can use the lasso tool as well. After that, break the partition as follows. After that, right click inside of the path and then select mix selection over there. And then click on OK. After that, select any selection tool and then right click inside of the selection and then select layer via cut option over there. So as you can see, a new layer has been created with the model face selection inside of it. So make the original face layer active by again clicking on it. So now make the selection of the second part of the division using pen tool or lasso tool. After that, again right click inside of the path and then select make selection option and then click on OK. After that, select any selection tool and then right click inside of the selection and then select layer via cut option. And then make the original image layer active by clicking on it. After that, repeat the same process for the third partition and fourth partition. So now as you can see, each partition of the face image is into a new layer. So now we don't need these lines over here, so for that you can delete the partition layer or else you can hide it as well. Now we need to create a group for each of the partition layer, so for that make the top partition layer active by clicking on it and then after that press Ctrl plus G to create a group for it. After that, make the second partition layer active by clicking on it and then create a group for it by pressing Ctrl plus G. So like this, we do this for all the partition layers. So as you can see, the 5 partition groups have been created. After that, make the top partition group layer active by clicking on it and then select Move tool and then using Move tool, place the top layer properly. Now I'm minimizing this group. After that, select the second partition group and then using Move tool, place it below like this way. After that, make the layer inside of it active by clicking on it and then create a new layer by clicking on create new layer icon. After that, drag that layer below the face model layer. So now we need to create an elliptical background for this partition. So for that, select pen tool or else you can select lasso tool as well. And then using pen tool, create an ellipse as follows. After that, right click inside of the path and then select option make selection. And then click on OK. After that, select paint bucket tool. And now set the foreground color as the color which you want to fill inside of this ellipse, which is light blue over here. After that, using paint bucket tool, click inside of the selection as follows. So as you can see, the ellipse has been filled with that of blue color. After that, press Ctrl plus D to deselect the selection and then using move tool, place the ellipse properly so that it fits the head. So now this looks proper. So after that, minimize that group and place that group properly using move tool. After that, make the third partition group layer active by clicking on it and then using move tool, bring that grouper down little bit. After that, again make the face image layer inside of the group active and then create a new layer by clicking on create new layer icon. Now bring the newly created layer below the face image layer. After that, select pen tool and then create an ellipse as follows. After that, right click inside of the path and then select make selection option and then click on OK. After that, select paint bucket tool and now set the foreground color as the color which you want to fill inside of this ellipse. And then using paint bucket tool, fill the selection with that of color. After that, press Ctrl plus D to deselect the selection. And then using move tool, place the color layer properly. Now if some of the color is coming out of the face as you can see over here, then all you need to do is click on add layer mask icon and then select brush tool. Select brush as hard round and then using brush tool, hover over that portion which you want to remove. So now this looks proper. After that, minimize this group and then using move tool, place it properly. So now do the same thing for the third partition and the fourth partition. So now this looks proper, but we still need to add shadows to each of the color to make it look more proper and realistic. So for that, make the second partition group layer active by clicking on it. Now expand it. And then make the color layer inside of it active by clicking on it. After that, again create a new layer by clicking on create new layer icon. After that, right click on the newly created layer and then select option create clipping mask. After that, select brush tool. Then select brush as soft round. After that, set the foreground color as black. And then using brush tool, hover over as follows. You can increase and decrease the size of the brush using the square bracket keys of your keyboard. So as you can see, it adds a black color over here, which gives a nice shadow effect. So like this way, we need to do this for all the color layers over here. So now this looks perfect. So now let's create a background for this image. So for that, create a new layer by clicking on create new layer icon, and then place that layer at the bottom. After that, click on create new fill or adjustment layer icon and then select gradient option. After that, select the gradient as black white. Then set the style as radial. Angle as 90 degrees. Click on this reverse option. And then scale it to 300%. And then click on OK. So as you can see, this looks good now. Now let's place the face at the center of the document. So for that, make the top group layer active by clicking on it. After that, press shift and select the last partition group, which will give you the selection of all the groups in between as well as the selection of the two layers. After that, select move tool and then using the move tool, place the face at the center of the document. So now this looks proper. So after that, we need to add shadow at the bottom of the face. So for that, make the gradient background layer active by clicking on it. And then create a new layer by clicking on create new layer icon. And then select brush tool. Brush as soft round. And then select foreground color as black. Now using brush tool, click on the document as follows. After that, press Ctrl plus T. After that, scale that layer as follows. After that, click on the stick icon to place it. Now using move tool, place it properly. After that, reduce the opacity of the layer to 80%. So that's it guys, this will give you your slice face color effect in Photoshop. Now if you guys like this video, then hit the like button. Also share it to the ones who might be interested in such videos and subscribe to the channel for more videos in Photoshop. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.